My name is Kate Garcia, and I have a company called Stripy Lizard Creative Services, which is based in Faversham. And I have been asked to curate this show. The theme is very loose this year. We're basically celebrating the fact that it's a fifth year anniversary. I've been working with Pin Baxter this year in particular. She was asked to be patron in 2017. So it's lovely to be working with her and Ken and all the staff at the Alexander Centre while we put this collection together. Okay, Stephen Rose was born in Essex, but he's lived in Kent for a long time. He's very well known all over the world.
Hello, my name's Stephen Rose. I'm an artist. I'm a painter in oil, principally. I draw. I paint almost exclusively from life. I don't use photography as part of my process of painting. I paint a lot of flowers, and I enjoy painting flowers. And I'm always looking at ways of presenting flowers that are kind of slightly different and more contemporary. So I wrapped them in cellophane and I bought little reservoirs, and I stuck each tulip in a little reservoir so it'd stay alive. But tulips being tulips, they want to find the light. And so as I was painting, I realized this could be an unwanted bouquet that had been cast aside for a while.
We chose Tim Benson because of his work with a company, a charity based in Africa called Orbis.
My name is Tim Benson. I'm a portrait painter working exclusively in oil paints. So I went out to rural Zambia, in northern Zambia, beginning of last year, and met approximately 30 people in the community, both nurses, doctors, and patients, who had come in from far and wide to have really life-changing operations to actually restore their sight. So, you know, seeing children opening their eyes and seeing things properly for the first time is just—it's an incredible thing. It's an incredible thing to behold. It really is. So, these are the areas that the things that I really am very, very interested in is telling stories through portraiture and building awareness about international issues.
Jeff Lowe, I really like his work, actually. I like sculpture myself, and it really resonated with me. This year he's actually put in some paintings that are still very sculptural.
Well, I'm primarily a sculptor, so at the end of the day when I'm making sculptures, and it's quite a sort of physical activity, I like to work on paper. I started working with wood blocks and printing rather than drawing or painting direct onto paper, which I found a much more sculptural approach. So they have a very strong link to sculpture. They're not made to assist the sculpture. They're not made as sort of preliminary drawings or prints for sculptures. But I often find that when I do them, a year or two later, I'm actually making things that have some resemblance or link to the works on paper. With the works, I try to use colours that I might not actually feel comfortable with. So I try to shock myself a little bit.
I first knew of Peru because he has just moved into, it's just at the top of Preston Street, where the Alexander Centre is, and I've been following his work on his website, and his work resonates with me a lot. I love the boldness and the pushiness of some of his work. So he's internationally known and loved, but more so in Faversham, I think.
So this is one of 20 portraits, self-portraits, for a project that I call Coulrophobia, which is the fear of clowns. I hate clowns, and I think it's important as a photographer to either photograph things you love or hate, and I hate clowns. So I first of all photographed maybe 50 clowns at a clown convention in Bognor Regis, and decided I hate clowns even more. And then we used to have studio parties at my studio where we'd have clown face parties. So people would come to the parties with clown face. They could wear whatever clothes they wanted, but they had to have clown makeup on. So it was very popular with celebrities and people that were quite famous because nobody could recognize them. They were quite crazy parties. And so for every party, I'd get a makeup artist to do my makeup. And then we started photographing those looks. So it started off just for fun for these parties. Then after a while, I sort of started approaching other better makeup artists. And this book is 19 makeup artists, the top makeup artists in the world, and Marilyn Manson also doing my makeup. But this particular makeup is by a German makeup artist called Lonnie Bauer. And this is one of my favorites from the setup. The book is called Coulrophobia.
We chose Gabrielle Nesfield, and her work is very abstract and very bold and bright, and we thought it would go well with Jeff Lowe's work.
What starts as a subject, a springboard, with its own kind of reality, as I work, the sort of reality of the actual painting takes over. And so I never quite know where it's going. So I might, for example, this is from a completely different set of drawings I did, this little figure here, and so is that one. So in fact, I married work that I'd done in Copenhagen with ideas that I had at home. So it's a kind of mixture. And then the painting takes over, and the color takes over, and the sort of shape of these plinths take over, and the painting leads me.
We were approached by Toby Pinn. He's a Faversham-based photographer.
My name is Toby Pinn. I do wedding portraiture. I also video weddings, but my main interest is portraiture. My work currently at the Alexander Centre is a portfolio of people with tattoos, so 10 to 15 images of local people with their tattoos.
In the last two or so years, we've decided, as part of our vision for the Alexander Centre, is to showcase the work of emerging artists from Faversham mainly. This year, we now can proudly show the work of one lady whose name is Bonnie Johnson, who has just left sixth form from the Abbey School.